I'll start by creating a new Java project. Here I'll just have one class with a main method. It's going to be in this package. I will need the RX Java jar that we downloaded in previous tutorials. So I'm going to copy it from here and drop it here and go to right click and properties and Java build path, add jar. I will be using here this array, shapes array, and the shapes list that's based on that array. Here I will have examples of using the observable from and the observable just and observable create. Now observable from creates an observable instance from various Java structures, so I'll be using this method that returns an observable and takes in an iterable and instances from classes implementing the iterable interface can be passed including any Java collection. So here we'll be using it for this shapes list. And I will also be using another overloaded from method in order to create observable instances from arrays. So we'll be passing it here the shapes array and it's gonna return an observable. So I can do observable.from actually. Let's take this out. And I need the RX one. And I'm passing in the shapes list. And then I'm gonna call subscribe. And I'll pass in those. So the onNext method is gonna print out what's going in, and for the onError we're just gonna print out the error, and for uncompleted I'll just print out completed and say list. And actually I can do the exact same thing except using this overloaded method and passing in the shapes array. So let me go ahead and test run it. So here we go, it printed out what's in that list based on that array, so rectangle, square and triangle, then completed list, and the same thing, rectangle, square and triangle, and completed array. So from converts various objects and data types into observables And in RX Java, the from operator can convert an iterable, an array, or a future. And in the case of an iterable or an array, the resulting observable will emit each item contained in the iterable or array. Now, when we want to create the observable instance from a single object, we use the observable.just method, and this method emits its parameters as onNext notifications, and afterwards it emits an uncompleted notification. And this method allows up to 9 objects of the same type to be observed. So I'm doing here exactly the same as we did here for from, except I'm using just with the shapes list, and same thing just with the shapes array. Let's go ahead and test run it. So this is from the from, and for just, this is what comes out. So just is similar to from, but from will dive into an array or an iterable to pull out items to emit, while just will simply emit the array or iterable unchanged as a single item. So in RX Java, the just method accepts between 1 and 9 items as parameters and returns an observable that emits those items in the same order as they were given in the parameter list. Now observable.create takes a parameter of the type unsubscribe and returns an observable. And the unsubscribe interface extends action1 interface, which has one method, and that method takes one argument of type subscriber and does not return anything. And that method will be called when the observable.subscribe method is invoked. So I'll do observable.create. And I'll use a lambda expression, since unsubscribe has only one method, and that method takes one argument of type subscriber. So what's passed in is going to be a subscriber, and so that method does not return anything. So this is going to happen inside that method. And I don't need this. Just say subscriber. So we can create an observable from scratch using the create operator. And we pass this operator a function that accepts the observer as its parameter. And we write this function so that it behaves as an observable by calling the observers onNext, onError, and onCompleted methods. So we'll do a try catch, and we'll catch any exception. And here I'll check if the subscriber is not unsubscribed, then I'll trigger the onError method, subscriber.onError. Now to trigger the onNext and onCompleted, I'll start by picking up an iterator from the shapes list, and I'll do while iterator.hasNext. If the subscriber is unsubscribed, then I'll go ahead and return. Otherwise, I'll trigger subscriber.onNext, passing in iterator.next. And afterward, I'll trigger the onCompleted method. So if not subscriber dot is unsubscribed, then I'll go ahead and do subscriber dot onCompleted. And we're gonna get back an observable that I can call subscribe on it. So let's copy from here. And let's go ahead and test run it. Here we go. So rectangle, square, and triangle, and then completed.